हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल आर्ट स्फीयर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम रियली सॉरी फॉर बीइंग इनकंसिस्टेंट फॉर द वीडियोस। द लास्ट वीडियो विच आई अपलोडेड वाज इन सितंबर एंड आई एम रियली सॉरी फॉर दैट। आई वाज लाइक कॉट अप इन सम कमीशंस एज वेल एज माय बोर्ड्स एंड माय एंट्रेंस एग्जाम विच आई विल बी हैविंग इन द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रुअरी एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई वाज नॉट एबल टू मेक द वीडियो एंड सॉरी फॉर दैट। बट हियर आई हैव ऑल द वर्क्स विच आई डिड during this pandemic situation, so I'll be showing you that. If you're following me on Instagram, I put up a story regarding if you want to see my portfolio or not, because I was not really sure about that if you'll be, you know, wanting to see it, but the response was good and hence here we are. It's a huge portfolio. This is not the only thing. I have other sketchbooks as well, so I'll divide it into maybe two or three parts depending upon the time, whatever time is there. So without any further ado, I'll start. The guidelines which are there for the class 12 portfolio, your teacher must have shared it with you, and if not, I will just write the basic things in the description, what is required, what is like compulsory which you need to put in your portfolio. Rest other things, of course, you can add or subtract according to your wish. Okay, so here the portfolio which is there right in front of you, I have made it myself, whole thing, the outside cover, the basic structure, everything I have made myself, the fold files, the folders which are there inside it, and everything I made myself. So the folder which is available in the market, it is very small according to the size of sheets which we are required to submit during the practical exam. We are required to submit most of our final works should be of A2 size, but the portfolio which we get in the market, it doesn't accommodate A2 size in it. I don't know why they call it A2 size portfolio. So here I made it by myself, and if you can try making it, because it's not very difficult. You just have to take a cardboard, fold it into two halves, and then just put up a paper. And if you do not want to decorate it like this, it's fine. You can just write normal portfolio, your name, class and roll number and teacher, submitted to and submitted by, whatever is written in the format. Here I have done the texture behind this whole cover page because I didn't want to keep it plain white. So the texture that I have done here is in pink and white mix. Basically this is crimson. I have mixed it with white, and hence I've got different shades in it. So the basic theme of the cover page is cherry blossoms. I did this during the New Year time, so I was very happy at that time. And I generally like to accommodate colors which I'm feeling. Like if I'm feeling very sad, so I'll accommodate some cool color, blue maybe. And when I'm feeling very happy, I try to accommodate warm colors. Like we have red, we have yellow. These are warm colors. If you have studied color theory, you must know it and you should know it if you are in art field. Okay, so according to that, and this thing I have mentioned in my artist statement also, so it shows that how I have, you know, practically implemented what I have written in my artist statement. I'll talk about the artist statement afterwards. So here I have just written portfolio right in front of it and my name and class. So when we open this whole portfolio, it's divided into two parts. One is final work and one is sketches. Now these folders also I have made myself, and I have labeled them for just making it convenient for the examiner to know that these are the final works and these are just sketches. I'll show you both. We'll start with final work. So in class 12 portfolio, I have also added some of my 11th class works, because class 12 portfolio is supposed to be a developing portfolio. There are two types of portfolio. One is static, where you put your best works in it, and one is developing, where you show how you have, you know, developed from one stage to another. So in the starting, the best ones are there, and then at the end I have my 11th class portfolio works as well. So in the starting we have artist statement. So what I have done in all my works is I have mounted them on different color sheets. Some are on white, some are on blue, some are on yellow, depending upon the color. again, color wheel, color theory is there in this stuff. So here I used Scarlet Lake I used for the background. So Scarlet Lake is basically red. So I just did a wash of it with watercolors, and I have used yellow behind this just to make it pop up. Otherwise it was looking very plain and very simple. So this yellow background adds a lot of, you know, importance to this whole statement. I'll not show the close-up because you are supposed to write it by this. Okay, so we can start with the next one. Okay, this still life was done in my pre-board one, which was there in December. We have two practicals, right? One is still life and one is composition. So our teacher showed this image to us because it was done online, and then we painted it. I have added in my portfolio as well, and I'm very happy about it. I posted this picture on Instagram as well, and this is one of my favorite still life. I just love it. Okay, so the next one is also my favorite. This is a sketch of a horse. The video is there on my YouTube channel. You can check it out. I'll link it down in the description as well. I have 2-3 works which are there in the video in my portfolio. So you can always check it out and see the whole process, how I made it. In this, I'll just be showing the work. This and also I'll tell you about the time. Sorry, I forgot about this. This was done in 3 hours. And this took around a week or so to complete, and I'm very happy about it. And that's the only issue where, you know, I'm very scared that the examiner is going to take my works. Because I do not want, because we do not get the works back after the exam. The school also takes a work, and then I don't know where they are kept. But the examiner also takes maybe 1 or 2 work of each child, so be prepared for that. So this is again a charcoal sketch of a tiger. Again, the video is there on my YouTube channel. You can check it out there, and if you want to see. Now this I have mounted on a white sheet because it's a black. It's a charcoal sketch. It's a black sketch. So hence it will look nice on white. If I would have, you know, put something like yellow, maybe that yellow will take over this black. So I think white is looking better than yellow in this case. Again, this video is also there on my YouTube channel. You can again check it out there. So this also took around 1.5 weeks to complete, and this is also one of my favorite. I love his eyes, and this portion I just love this. I'm obsessed with my words. Next one, this is the sketch of an old lady. That old man was inspired by this old lady. I was inspired by this old lady to make one more sketch and make a video of this. I didn't make the video of this one because it was my first charcoal sketch, detailed one. So that's why I was not really sure about that, if I wanted to film it or not. This took around a week or so. And by a week, I mean around 8 or 7 hours every day, around minimum. Sometimes it is more as well. It can be 10 also, 12 also, and it can be less as well, depending upon how much, you know, I have, how much energy I have, because I have school as well and other things also going on. Okay, so this is a sketch of my sister and my Jiju. It's not very good because I made it when the pandemic just started, around in April or May I made it, and at that time I didn't have a lot of practice, but still I feel it's good according to the kind of practice or the kind of work I used to do at that time. It's pretty good. I didn't have a lot of practice of these portraits at that time, so according to that it's very good. Okay, this is a fashion illustration which we did in our class. So I did this one. This is a bridal dress. I really like these detailed bridal dress by Sabya Sanchi. So this you can say is kind of inspired by him, though I didn't use any picture, but I had an idea what kind of work I wanted in this one. Okay, so this is a still life study of a bamboo plant. So this is also has compositional elements to it. The main focus is going like from here to here, you can say. Like there's a wheel in this whole thing, circle in this whole thing, you know. And that is the main thing about composition. Your composition should take your viewer inside your artwork. So that's there in this one. This is done with Staedtler Luna watercolor based pencils. So this is, again, I'm very proud of this one. And the background also I chose according to the color. It was green, so I thought yellow will make it pop. This one is a quick study of a master study of John Singer Sargent, and this took around 20 minutes to complete. And this is a very recent sketch. I did it in the month of December, maybe during my pre-boards. Again, this is also a master study of John Singer Sargent. I just love his works, the kind of strokes that are there in his work. I'm, you know, like surprised. I want that kind of perfection in my work, where like if you see like close up, it's these just brush strokes are there, but when you go far away, the painting is going to look amazing. I want that kind of thing in my work. It's going to require a lot of practice work. Okay, so this is an artistic work. It's a monoprint work which we did in the class. I have one more that is there in this rough sketches one. I didn't put it in this one because I didn't like that a lot. Okay, this is a watercolor composition of Kedarnath temple. So there are mountains in the background and the temple and people. So basically the topic for this was tourist destination. So I really like this place because I have visited there once when I was a child. I really liked it, so accordingly I have done. This again took around a week or so. Okay, this is a composition which for my pre-board, which was there in the December. So this is what I did, and I have added it in my portfolio. Again, what I told you about taking your viewer inside the picture. So this is basically that. This has a lot of perspective in it, this painting. So it is taking the viewer inside the painting to this picture. From here, then it is coming back. So there's a circle and you can literally travel the whole painting like that. It can go like this also and then come like this. So there are various ways. It depends upon you how you see a painting or a composition. What I feel maybe is different from what you feel. So this is a quick study in watercolors. This is done on matte paper, handmade paper. So the matte, there are two types of watercolor paper. I give some gyan also in between about the sheets and whatever I have used. So the check paper has small checks. I'll give a close-up picture of this, and you can get various texture with this. And depending upon what you want to use it on, some people like this texture, some people like rough paper. So there are these two different kind of watercolor sheets. Okay, so again, this was the first video which was uploaded on my channel, so you can check it out there. This took around 4 to 5 days. Okay, and this was my first colored still life, and it is done in acrylics. I really like this one, the color. And especially this glass bottle. Okay, so this was a quick work done with brush strokes. So there, this is not a very finished work, I will say. It has a lot of brush strokes, a lot of impression into it. So just to give a, you know, dynamic approach to the whole portfolio, I have added various mediums and various kinds of work. So I wanted to add something like this, which has brush strokes in it. I really like this part. This was the first time that I painted flowers, and I think I'm very happy with that, according to me. And the vases, of course, it's amazing. Okay, so here we have this delight. This was for my half yearly exam. Again, this was done in 3 hours. I don't like it a lot, I don't know. I'm happy with some parts, but I'm not very happy. Okay, this is a watercolor composition again, and this was for a competition by Government of India, in which we had to show fusion of two cultures. So the theme was Chandigarh and Daman and Diu. So we had to do fusion of these two. So this is what I made. So this is their folk dance, the tribal dance. These are masks which are used while in their festivals. These masks are used. They are huge. And here I have made those rock garden dolls. If you have visited a rock garden, you must have seen that there are dolls made with bangles. They are very pretty. And here I have made 2 boys playing dhol and 2 girls are dancing in the traditional wear. And Chandigarh sign and the place where these all are dancing is Sukralik. You can see the mountains behind and the forest that is there. I really like this one. The colors, matlab, the impression of watercolor is actually there in this painting. So that's why I really like it. Okay, so in our syllabus we have Rajasthani miniature painting. So we got a project regarding the same, that we had to make our own miniature painting, and the topic was quarantine or lockdown. So basically this lady or this girl is sitting inside the house, and there are birds, there's a peacock sitting in the tree outside the window, and again the same situation that was there, that the humans, they were locked inside their houses, and the birds and animals, they were moving freely, and they were also happy. We were not happy, some of us. I was very happy. And the border, you can see that the work which is done in the corners, this is you might have seen these kind of pattern on, if you have visited Taj Mahal. This is Persian style illustration, you can say, illustration it is called. So this is that, just to give it a nice vintage feel to it, I have used the colors accordingly. Green, red, again complementary colors, they are going to make each other pop out. So color theory is everywhere. Again, I've used a blue background because there's a peacock inside. Otherwise this peacock was taking all the attention, because this was the only blue thing in this whole composition. If you'll see, this whole composition is very cool, is very warm, but this peacock is very cool. So just to balance the both the things, I have used blue background. This is the only one which has a blue one. Okay, so this one is, we had a assignment where we had to study various textures. So basically we will keep a paper on a surface and then we'll do pencil colors on top of that. So whatever is the impression on the surface, it will come on the paper, and then we just had to make a collage out of it. This is that. Again, this is a fashion illustration. Okay, so now I think I have my 11th class work. So you can of course see the difference between class 12th work and class 11th work. So nobody is born with this kind of, you know, technique or skill. It is developed with time and with practice. So this one, though it was the last work of class 11th, the composition which I did, so it is pretty much better if you'll compare it to others. But again, it has, the composition is very good. It is taking the viewer inside the whole painting. So that is very important in any composition, that your viewer is going inside the painting, that you are making your viewer go inside your painting, because that's the whole point of a composition. I didn't know about fixative at that time, so hence I have used butter paper on it. But now I use fixative spray on all my works. that they stay intact. So this still life is turning class 11, and during December or something of that session I did it. So again, it is pretty good if we'll compare to others. Now, a class 12th work also I have included the best ones. I have not included which were, you know, really bad. So these are also filtered works, you can say. Again, composition, there are a lot of mistakes in this one, but still I've added to show that yes, I have overcome my fear or my mistakes, and I have added a lot of perspective in my class 12th work. That was a fear which I had. I didn't add a lot of perspective. You can see there's only one vanishing point over here, and these divider is also not correct if you go according to this, and the figures are also very small, and it's not really cool. I should not be giving a critique about my own work, but that's it. Okay, so this is a kite flying scene. Again, not very finished. It lacks light and dark shades both. Basically, medium tones are there. The light tones and the dark tones both are missing. That's the issue which I had in my view. Okay, so this is even bad, like worst, but still I'll show. So I am showing this work just to show that, you know, everyone can improve. The only thing is you need to give time to it. This is also very bad. The proportions are horrible. The sky, the brush strokes are visible in this one, though it was not required or it was not my agenda to show. The buildings, again, the dark tones are missing over here in the building. The car is okay, I won't say, but the face and everything is very bad. I do not like this one. Okay, so my final work are finished. Okay, hello everyone. So sorry for interrupting in between, but video bahut lambi ho gaya, so I'll have to divide it into maybe 2 or 3 parts, because I want the video to be short and so that you are able to enjoy it. I do not want the video to be of 1 hour and then you're not able to see the whole video. So I'll divide it into parts and then I'll upload it. So that's it for today. I hope you liked the video and the whole portfolio. Comment down below if you liked any sketch or what was your favorite composition sketch, whatever you liked throughout the portfolio. And you can comment whatever your views were about my portfolio, and you can share your portfolio pictures on Instagram with me. I have all the social media links in the description below, with the videos of the horse and the sketch of a horse and old man and the still life. I'll put the links in the description. So if you want to see the whole process, you can just go in the description and you can click on the link to be able to see that. So thank you very much, everybody. I hope you have liked this video and you have commented down below whatever your views were, and you have subscribed to my channel. And at last, please do share it with your friends, family, everybody, because this was not a tutorial. It was a fun video. I showed my work. I displayed the whole portfolio. So you can share it with everybody, regardless of that person is in art field or not. It will be fun for everyone. So thank you very much. Bye-bye.